That color is incredible. It's incredible. Today's video we'll be making one roasted tomato soup, amigos. I'm for sure you're going to love it. Basically what I'm going to use, two Roma tomatoes, a little bit of bell pepper, same with cherry tomatoes, because they're getting old. What else? Bell pepper, I say bell pepper, shallot, garlic, salt, black pepper, olive oil, a little bit of cayenne. I'm going to salt it. Once I salt them, I'm going to keep our finished day cooking over there. Yes, over here. In one, also you can do it in your oven, roaster is not a big deal. What else? I'm gonna make one pesto as a garnish also. And that's it. It's very simple. I'm gonna make it less than 30 minutes for two people, and that's it. Amigos, thank you for playing this video. If you don't know me, my name is Ulises Cruz. I'm a professional chef. I started doing plant-based cuisine the last 5 years. Something that I really love is just made vegan dishes as this recipe. So amigos, let's do it. So then amigos, once a spot, bring it to the heat, medium high heat, 1 to 2 tables of olive oil, and remove the curd. So we're gonna cut it on quarters also. So also I'm gonna cut it on quarters. You know, I'm gonna use one small shallot. I'm gonna just clean it very well and slice it. So also I'm gonna use 2 garlic cloves. So before saute, just preheat your oven. 350 degrees. I mean 350 degrees Fahrenheit. So it's gonna get it hot while we're sauteing it does. Onions and my ingredients. I mean, my greens, my veggies, you know. Okay. So amigos, add the rest of your ingredients. Then 2 Roma tomatoes and something like 1 cup of cherry tomatoes also. A little bit of salt. Black pepper. And a pinch of cayenne. Amigos, and don't be like me. Don't forget your bell pepper. I mean, it's optional. Just remember that. Just I'm gonna use a little bit half of bell pepper. Don't forget your bell pepper. I almost forget that. So, amigos, and I'm gonna add a little bit of brown sugar or coconut sugar just to reduce the acidity. So, something like 1 tablespoon. So when you already cook them a little bit, it's time to put in your oven. 20 to 25 minutes, 35 degrees Fahrenheit. So I'll be back. So then amigos, for my tomato pesto, 1 saucepan. And also. I'm gonna toast it a little bit of pine nuts. Yeah. So amigos, now finally, so good. So amigos, if you don't have oil in your tomatoes or you have dry tomatoes like us, just chop it a little bit. Give it an easy word or give it that easy word to your food processor. Just a little bit, just a couple dry tomatoes or some dry tomatoes. If there is a little bit of oil, just add it. It's much better, this oil. I mean, this they come with olive oil sometimes. So, a little bit of sun-dried tomatoes, and also I'm going to add it. So I'm going to use a little bit of grape seed oil and blend it. Also, this is getting dry, but this, the flavor is still in there, it's just parmesan cheese. bit more. There are small more pieces, but amigos, you choose your texture. So there we go. Just as a garnish, a little bit, just as ready tested, and it's good. For sure. So the color is gonna change if you're using fresh sun-dried tomatoes. I mean, as much one lightly color instead of browny color, instead of too brown or too black. But anyway, it's not about the color, it's about the flavor. Oh la la, look at this beauty. So once you have iron until this point, it's time to add a little bit of vegetable broth. Vegetable broth, come on here. I know, looks too light, right? But it's good, I made it yesterday. Wow. Oh my God, smell incredible. Something like half cup. So amigos, this is crucial. If you want to add a little bit of creaminess to your soup, just add a little bit of cream. Yes, just add a little bit of cream. Once you boil it again, just bring it into your blender. Just be careful, don't be like Ulysses. Put it in a blender. Put in your blender. And it's time to blend all. Wow, the color is incredible. The flavor is incredible. Right now it's time to plate it. So what kind of garnish? One garnish. Amigos, I got my garnish here. A little bit of some basil. Oh my God, I found the right bowl here. And amigos, there we go. Little bit of sun dry and couple leaves of basil. So amigos, I'm done. I hope you get this recipe or this idea. Look at this, the color is incredible. It's incredible. This is just one idea, amigos. I really like it to share with you. And I appreciate if you were out of this part. See you soon, I'll catch you later. Peace and love your tomato soup.